Hello and welcome to another Ranked Replaycast. And this is the most disappointing game I had, because it was the one that I lost where I only needed one star to get to rank one. So it was my last game. After that, the queue wasn't filled anymore and I couldn't get another game in. And I had, of course, two stars left. So yeah, and time was running short as well. Yeah, why do I show it to you? Well, I will explain a bit what I'm thinking about the ranked or conclude about the last ranked season. I mean, some who are part of my Discord can maybe remember the rage comment I made after this game here. And yeah. All right, that game starts with a really promising thing. Our Yu Yang has no radar. Perfect, does work really well, but okay, we can live with that. I mean, I saw worse. Then I checked the lineup, and I played a lot with, and that's now really, really surprising for you, Boom, you're dead. He has a really, really bad reputation, and for a reason, but he's like, in Germany would say, he's the one-eyed among the blind, and yeah, another player I can remember that was pretty good was Dr. Sayus EU, and yeah, the rest is more or less unknown. Affirmative. Yeah, this Lippy Lip 90, I think I played one or two games with him. He was playing okay-ish, but yeah, you will see how this battle evolves, and yeah, how pissed I am afterwards. Okay, normally, well, not normally, but you have your little split going on between A and C. Shima, I'm supporting the Shima so he can be, in case we meet the other Shima. Of course, there is no communication and it's not so close like in clan battles where you have, like, get RPF infos and whatever. But I have RPF myself. I changed my Zhao build after a while because I was, yeah, feeling the need, even though I did want to avoid it. Alright, so we have now a Montana accompanied by Hindenburg as well. Pretty simple thing. I'm just waiting what they are up to. And at some point I will open the fire, because that Montana is coming pretty, pretty close here. And the Shima might get good Torp angles as well. And I'm letting my team know that they have both DDs at C. Our Shima is going really aggressive, means he's probably not going to see any. Or he's pretty sure that there is no DD in the vicinity. So the thing is, I'm not shooting because I don't want to, like, warn them or whatever. I mean, the Montana can, whatever, I don't care, shoot. But I don't want to give information away too early where our positions are. That's a thing a lot of people don't understand. They have no patience, they are just firing and shooting and whatever. Because it doesn't make any sense to, my god, this guy ate, like, the hell of a lot of torps. So, now, when we have the possibility of getting a kill, of course I'm starting to fire them. That's for sure. I think that shot was really bad. Especially with a Zhao, you want to be always. Yeah. Concealed and not firing all the time. You only fire all the time when it's, anyways, doesn't matter what you're doing, or if you need to deal damage to already hard damage like we see it here. But I'm not really lucky with my volleys there. Don't get any good pens, and yeah, it was a bit disappointing. Now Montana charges in. I'm okay with that. Unless or until he's not going to overcommit himself. And that's a big issue I see with a lot of battleships. But you will see this. Yeah, I'm already telling him go to back because we are going to finish this Montana without your help. And the enemy Hindenburg, I don't know who is JB, he does exactly what to do. He's going just to kite. And yeah, okay, this Montana is a bit tricky to kill, it looks like, but okay. We will get him eventually. So what would you do in a Montana right now? If the enemy Montana is dead. My aim is also horrible. It was early in the morning, so okay. But we would have finished the Montana 100%. So what would you do exactly now with your Montana? If you would be here. Would you push further into a Kurfürst, Yamato and a Hindenburg on your side? Nope, you want to avoid this. So you turn out and you go dark. And you get concealed. But just look what our Montana is doing. And he's... Is he going dark? That's the biggest question here. I mean, the distance is a bit... yeah, too short to go dark. But he's trying to turn away. So no clue how he can burn down that easily. I mean, okay, the Hindenburg has also... Pretty much is pretty lucky, but still. Was it necessary? And he has probably no real premium consumables, otherwise he would have been able to repair or heal or whatever. Instead he's just burning down like a crisp. And we trade and we it's just so embarrassing. And that's why I'm pissed already. Yeah, we were too slow. For what were we too slow? We are just... So, now the Kurfürst is going in. I mean, I can, like, operate with the Shima alone here. This Kurfürst can stay in this area and just shoot this guy from time to time. It doesn't matter. But he doesn't have to commit. We will push them out anyways. Regardless what's happening. Our Shima could go into straight into B. It doesn't matter. Yeah, and then you get always the same. You guys were hiding. Yeah, there was actually no need to like push or overextend. There was no need. But the fact that he burns down to one single Hindenburg in this short time tells me that he has no premium consumables, which on top is even way worse. And it just tells you how bad these players were at that point. And my conclusion for next season is, if I'm playing it, I will do it the first 2 weeks, I guess. I will push it through, and especially when it is tier 10, because this shit show I will never attend anymore. It makes absolutely no sense to play it on tier 10 with these kind of people. Absolutely no sense. If boom, you're dead. Is one of the best players in, among these people, then you actually know what's going on this and why you don't achieve anything. And the best thing about it, these people think, or most of the people think they don't play bad. And honestly, I can feel for them because if I would hang around like between 2 and 3 stars, like I did for like 50, 60 games, or even 70, then. Yeah, I would assume I'm not that bad either. So but you definitely see that you need to be on a killing streak to do something or to progress. Not killing streak, winning streak. This is just so embarrassing. Doesn't make any sense. It was so randomized, and yeah, that's what I'm really hated about this season. Yeah, what you see is now our Kurfürst getting burned to crisp. But honestly, no one of our DD's cares about smoking him up, maybe, but he's also not asking for help or so. The issue is I can't compete with the Hindenburg when it comes to burn down battleships. The Hindenburg is way, way stronger in this. Yeah, I'm asking next because we have now two caps, but if we lose him, then it's gonna be a tricky thing again. And I don't know why both of these are up here, down here, and these guys are still sitting here. I have no clue. These guys should evacuate immediately. But it looks as if our Kurfürst is committed because he has no, for whatever reason, ran into here. I don't know why. I have no clue. My aim was also on my dispersion. I don't know. It's also not so good. Yeah, Kurfürst is going in. Didn't check the minimap that we have to. That guy is also making a next bad decision. Yeah, that was inevitable that he eats torps 100% sure. He should have turned away. Just turned away. So that's two battleship of ours dead. So, and we are about to lose the third one. Because he doesn't go back. He thinks he needs to push. Why does he need to push? Why does he have to shoot? Play safe, please, man. He died horribly there in C. And then he's writing, play safe, please. And then get our Yu Yang gets detonated. And at that point, you think, wow. You're like one star away from ring one. I mean, in this, and you have the urgency to get it because the time is running out. Oh, great, yeah. You see how pissed I was. And I think many of you can understand why. So now I have to get away from the Hindenburg because he's otherwise. Burning me to crisp, but yeah. You see 5k on my Kurfürst. They don't even bother to shoot him anymore. Yeah, and then I get some stuff. I wrote idiots, only idiots, and this guy that died in C just said, yeah, you know, the super pro gamer in the last hour. Yeah, he's right. I'm probably the super pro gamer in the last hour. The thing is, I can't change anything. It doesn't matter. So, yeah. He is, of course, he said sorry. Normally, I could respect that, but honestly, after so many games that probably all of us played here, I don't want to hear a sorry or something. Then better play kind of safe and stay in a position where you can always disengage, because this is just shit show at its max. Then I'm ranting about BB players, but yeah, in general, yeah, my BBs died, but it doesn't count for only for the BBs. Everybody is going down and blah, blah, blah. I'm just telling them that the BB players will always charge in, especially, and some Hindenburg players will always capitalize on it and just burn them down, and they will never learn. They will never learn, and it's sad part about it, but it's how it is. Alright, so as a summary, yeah, I can tell you we lose this, but this is pretty obvious, I guess. Conclusion. Yeah. If it is tier 10 again, play in the first 2 weeks if you don't want to get into this show here. Probably win in the first 2 weeks and it's fine. What else could we say? Yeah, don't slack at all. I mean, normally I don't give a fuck too much, and I'm progressing pretty quick, but yeah, as you see, it goes down the road sometimes when you slack too hard. And that's the main conclusion I can make, and I hope that Wargaming will implement some other system with keeping the stars. Is not going to work out. Maybe a personal rating thingy. I don't know. Probably not. But yeah, I hope for some improvements. But the biggest hope I have is that it's not going to be tier 10 again. It's just too strong for that. It ends up in a random game, and you can't carry. You are too reliable on. Well, too. Dependent on your teammates, which is rather sad sometimes. Alright, yeah. Just wanted to show you that and hope it's not too insulting if someone was in there. Yeah, don't forget, it's not a personal thing, but some people should just consider playing or getting better or admitting that they are not that good, but then please don't play ranked. That's just the only reason that I can, or the only thing I can beg for next time. Yeah. That's it, basically. So, thanks for watching. Give it a like or not. Write something in the comments below. And, yeah. See you next time. Bye-bye.